Hi, this is Clay King, and I'm here on a job today where a water heater has had a malfunction, and it flooded this basement, and the water ran kind of sort of down here about this area here, along out to about just kind of touching this corner, missed this entertainment center by about 2 inches. And then ran along this way up to about the sofa chair, and then the remainder of this little L shape in this room got wet, and then a little bit behind this wall and in the furnace area where the water heater was located. And the water heater is kind of back here. It's really buried. They actually had to move the furnace to put this water heater in. So that's the water heater. There's like no room in here at all. So what we're going to try and attempt to do is, this unit has quite a bit of materials in it. So there are bookcases and lots of storage, and all the closets are full. And this little bit of space that we've created has taken us a while to create. We have this entertainment center that's here, a lot more storage that's here. There's just a logistical problem in, if you wanted to remove this carpet to replace it, it would be a lot of work to move all these contents out of the way to replace the carpet. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to save the carpet and the wet pad by using in-place drying. And we're doing that by using this attachment here, and it's called a water claw. And we put this on the wet carpet and the pad, and the carpet itself to the touch isn't that wet, but we put this on top of the carpet, and let me show you the bottom. And it's kind of a waffle pattern, and it's got little holes in it. And we pull a vacuum on this with a vacuum hose, and it sucks the water up through the pad and through the carpet and out. And it allows us to help save the carpet and the pad without pulling them up. So I'm putting the hose on here, and I'm going to turn on the extractor, and that's going to apply a vacuum. And so the vacuum hose is running along over to here and to this attachment. And I'm going to focus the camera down, and hopefully you can see that water is actually being sucked up out of the pad and the carpet and migrating towards this hose. We usually stand on top of this, and that's how I use it, but it's hard for me to show you this and stand on it at the same time. But this is how the water is sucked up out of the carpet and out of the pad. And we move this along. I will stand on it for a moment here. Stand on it, and I weigh too much. And then move the handle. It breaks the suction, sucks up some of the water that was trapped in the water claw. We put it back down and stand on it again. And when I stand on it again, more water is coming up. We move this across the carpet. You're supposed to wait about 8 or 10 seconds in between times and do it a couple of times. So you do this 2 or 3 times, and it removes most of the moisture from the carpet and the pad. This works fairly well. It's one of the best methods in the industry for saving the carpet and the pad. And just keep moving it along, standing on it, and it sucks out more of the water. And it's very hard to see the water actually in the carpet, and it's amazing sometimes how much actually comes out. Quite a bit comes out. And we keep doing that until we can't really find any more moisture, and then we go over this with a light wand and extract the top of the carpet. After we've done this process, we're going to set up containment around here with poly sheeting, and zip wall zip poles, which are over here. We're going to erect all these zip wall zip poles, and we're going to also install a ELE 6400 heat drying machine, as well as blowers and dehumidifiers as needed. We also have some magnets that we're going to use in the process to help hold up the poly. And we're going to contain this area that's gotten wet to focus the heat and the dry air so that it dries out. And we're actually going to leave this couch and this sofa chair inside the containment There just really isn't any place to put them, and it shouldn't hurt them. And we'll dry the carpet, the pad, and all the walls in place without removing anything. We'll show you this process a little further on in a few minutes. This is the ELE heat drying machine, and it's set up on three cords. And we've constructed this containment using zip wall, zip poles, and poly. And we put it up to the cross sections on the hung ceiling. That one's going to be moved over, that's just temporary at the moment, so we can get in and out. And then we've contained the wet area. We've done all the extraction with the water claw and a light wand, and then we've left these large pieces of furniture inside the contained area. They'll dry out the feet and we don't have to pack them out. We've got a little bit of damp wall around the edges, and we've put a turbo air mover on this rear section of wall, and then we've also installed a HEPA 500 air mover. And we're using that also as an air mover to turn the air in this area. We've also added one turbo mover. It's pretty hard to see, but it's in here and it's up against this corner in the wall. It's drying out two sections of wall at one time from the back. And with this equipment, this should be dry within 2 or 3 days. We should dry out all the carpet, all the pad, and then remove the containment. And they shouldn't really have to do anything when we're done. No stain to paint and no carpet to repair. This is the output of the ELE, and this is coming out at about 140 degrees. And we've tipped the back of the machine up in the air. This is something we commonly do. We've put blocks underneath the back, and we're tipping the machine up so that the hot air blows down and across the carpet in this contained area. It sweeps across the carpet and pulls the moisture out of the carpet, and then it goes up into the room. So we try to focus the heat on the wet area. And we use less air movers doing it this way, and we have more power for the machine. This should be dry in 2 or 3 days, and we'll pull the equipment out after we've checked it with all our meters to make sure that it's dry. Hi, it's Clay King, and we're still on this job where we've installed the ELE and containment to dry out an area that has gotten wet from a water heater that let go. We installed the ELE, an Evolution dehumidifier, a HEPA 500, and two dry ease air movers. I'm going to go inside the containment, open it up, and this is the ELE on the inside. The output temperature coming out of this is about 180 degrees right now. We've tested the carpet, the pad, and the walls, and all the carpet and the pad in this area is now dry, and all the walls are now dry. We've tested all these areas in here and around that section, including that outside wall, and this is all dry. We're going to be taking down the zip wall containment barriers now that this job is complete. And I also wanted to point out, I don't know if you can see it from this side or not, but we're using some of those magnets again. They're up here and they're holding this end. We really couldn't get a zip wall here because of the draperies here were in the way. We really couldn't set up the zip wall the way we wanted to, so we used the magnets to finish off the end, and that was able to provide us with the ability to hold the plastic up where we would not have been able to. But this job is now complete, and we will be shutting down the equipment and taking the equipment away and putting the furniture back, and there should be no repairs needed on this job. Everything's dry. We saved the carpet, the pad, and all the walls without damage. Thank you for watching. Clay King, AAA Flood Drying.